Thank you very much for having me.
A new squad for Bafana Bafana. This clearly shows that the team, it is a new era for Bafana Bafana.
It's a new dawn for Bafana Bafana, and it's time we begin to build. Football is a process and not an event, and some of the previous Bafana coaches have simply paid lip service to rebuilding. And when I look at the squad that have been put down by Shakes Mashaba, I'm very encouraged, I'm very excited. We've got to start somewhere, and I've got to get a coach who believes in the conviction of his heart to give youngsters a chance. And when you look at the defenders, two players come to mind. You look at Ricardo Kutse, 17, and Ayabulela Makaka, 18 years. And let me give you a small story. When Ayabulela went to training at Ayers this morning, he didn't know that he's in Bafana Bafana. After training, his players came to him and said congratulations, and he was asking them, what is the story here? And they said, you've been included in the Bafana Bafana squad. And the guy just burst into tears and cried. He's part of the squad that won the under 20 in Lesotho. So Shakes knows him, and he knows his capability and what he can bring onto the board. When you said you are going to build and you bring players who are over the hill, 30, 33, because you want to win at all costs, Mina, I commend Shakes for this squad. Even if they lose, I'll be very excited, because they would have lost and learned valuable lessons moving forward, and eventually the team will grow and come together.
Coudjoe, and talking about young players, I mean, you look at the goalkeeper as well. You look at the number one goalkeeper for the under 20, Dumisani Msibi. You look at Ayabulela there, who is the captain of the under 20 team. Look at Ricardo there. But you also look at David Zulu, who was the leading goal scorer in the NFD, who's at Chippa United, played only 3 EPSA Premiership games. It shows that he's got confident young players. He's got confident in players that can make impact in their teams and hopefully make impact in the national team.
It's not even about the confidence. A number of coaches we've had are looking at Europe. South African players playing in Europe, and when there's a derby, they go and sit there and watch the players. You see, Shakes Mashaba have once again demonstrated that he doesn't just watch South African players in Europe and the PSL. He even watched the National First Division. David Zulu scored 16 goals in the National First Division last season. And guess what? In the Premier Soccer League, our top goal scorer was Bernard Parker with 10 goals. David Zulu was injured towards the end of the season, and he didn't play for about 6, 7, 8 games. Meaning, had he not been injured and played, he would have passed the 20-goal threshold. And for me, that is an indication of faith. It's an indication also of a coach who's got his heart in the job he does. He watches all the game, and I'm saying it's a dawn of a new era. Because even now, players playing in NFD are going to put more effort. Aware that Shakes Mashaba is somewhere watching them, and if they put up the shift and play to the best of their abilities, they can represent their country. Gone are the days when you have to play for the established powerhouses in order to be called, or you have to leave South Africa to Europe. What I'm happy about is that a bulk of his players are playing in the Premier Soccer League. He has also appointed OD DG, Owen Dagama, as one of his assistants. You recall Owen Dagama won a major title with the then Silver Stars when they were in the first division, knowing that he's very competent. March on and came and coached Pirates. These are domestic local coaches who've got understanding of the mentality, what makes South African players cry, what makes them laugh, what makes them think, knows their weaknesses and strength. And putting the two together, they can come up with the players that can do the business. Guess what? The Germans that won the World Cup, a bulk of the players played in Bundesliga. They didn't play abroad. This is a good paradigm shift. Moving away from this so-called, you have to travel and play in England for us to see you on TV, therefore you are a star, you play for Bafana Bafana. No. You can be a nobody, a no-brand name, and become a Bafana player. And when, after all, in 1996, when South Africa put that team together, majority of them have not even kicked a ball elsewhere in a foreign land, but they were able to defeat Africa. And I've got all confidence in Shakes Mashaba that, given the opportunity, and under the president, Daniel Dan, saying, I'm not interested. It's not going to be a match that you must qualify for Morocco 2015. Therefore, if you don't qualify, we are not going to fire you. We are not going to say anything. We are just giving you a chance to build. And from 1997, Shakes Mashaba built the under 17 that included Benny McCarthy, that won a title in Africa and did well in the world. Again, they have gone to Lesotho with the under 20 and won the under 20 cup. So they are able to put together a team that will be able to do well. And in 2017 and 2018 and 2022, the team will be ripe and we are all going to sit here smiling, because I'm telling you, Imoto Chonchimali, Abantu, they are going to play, and they are going to play their socks off and make me smile, make every South Africa very happy. And that's what football is about. Football is a process, not an event.
Coudjoe, you've wrapped it up. I was going to have a couple of more questions for you, but because of time, unfortunately, we have to end the interview there. And thank you very much for joining us to give us your analysis on the new Bafana Bafana era that Shakes Mashaba is building there and guiding the team, and hopefully to the 2015 African Cup of Nations. And that was Coudjoe Amankwaa, sports analyst. And that is where